Hi, I'm Claire. I'm French and I'm a third year grad student here at UW Bio. I'm studying how honeybees learn and process visual stimulus.
Hi, I'm Mira. I'm from Singapore, but I've been living in the US since 1998 when I was 19 years old, which makes me older than you might think a grad student is allowed to be. But I study how climate influences interactions between plants and insects in mountain meadows.
Hopefully, if you're watching this video, you already have an idea of the kind of research that interests you, have polished up your CV, and have a few faculty members in your head that you think you might like to join their lab. If you aren't there yet, look at the description box. We will link to another video.
This video is designed to help you make contact with potential PhD advisors. So number one, when should you start? As a general rule, about 2 or 3 months before the deadline for any given program is a good time to start emailing professors. By that time, faculty are likely to know whether or not they're going to take on any new students for that year, and UW Biology's application is usually due around the beginning of December, so anytime mid-September to October is a good time to start.
Number two, what should my subject line, greeting, and sign-off be? Use a subject line that is straightforward and direct, such as inquiry from a potential PhD student. Always start your first email with something like, Dear Dr. Amazing Scientist or Professor Amazing Scientist. And your sign-off could be anything from respectfully, best wishes, yours sincerely, or thank you. All of them are great. And remember to use a professional email address too. Use your school address if possible and avoid anything that you picked up because you thought it was funny. You will have plenty of time to be funny after you get to know your advisor.
Number three, what should I say in my email? This is pretty simple and you can do it in two short paragraphs. First, introduce yourself. So you want to cover who you are, for example, a senior at your university, why you're emailing, you want to join their lab, and something about why you want to pursue a PhD. So maybe you want to work as an industry scientist, become a conservation researcher, a research professor, or work in outreach and education, anything like that. It is totally okay if you don't know what you want to do after grad school, but professors are going to want to know something about why you're willing to spend 5 or 6 years doing something that's really, really hard. This is also where you can talk a little bit about your previous research experiences, but you don't have to go into great detail because you should also attach your CV to the email.
Second, explain why you're reaching out to this particular professor. A potential advisor wants to know why you think their lab is a good fit for you. A way to do that is to mention a recent paper of them, hopefully they're on your list because you like what they're publishing, and mention a question that the paper made you think of, or think of a way you might add to their current project. For example, you could say, I read your paper in Fancy Journal about how species interaction can shape the way organisms respond to climate change. And I think it would be very interesting to build on your research about tree community on Mount Rainier. For example, I'm very interested in testing whether the relationship between the white park pine and their seed dispersal can affect tree migration as climate warms.
Claire, have you been reading my email? That is exactly what I wrote to my current advisor 3 years ago, but it's not what I actually ended up doing research on in the end. And that's an important point. No one is going to hold you to the first ideas that you propose. Potential advisors just want to know that you have scientific ideas. Okay, so the last thing that you want to do before you sign off is let them know that you are available to meet, and you can suggest meeting either by Skype or if you happen to be in the same city as them, say that you're willing to meet in person and that you're looking forward to hearing from them.
Before you send your email, we strongly advise you to ask someone else to look at it, especially someone from the academic world. They can help you fix typo and look if you missed anything important.
Here's a checklist of things to do.
One thing to know is that professors are often behind on their email. They may be out on the field or traveling, especially in the summer. So a good thing is to send your first email very early so you have time to send reminders if your first email goes unanswered. So do not hesitate to send a mail saying, just checking in a week or two after your first message.
We hope that you find this video helpful, and we'll link to some more resources in the description box below. Good luck. Maybe we'll see you here at UW.